Welcome to the Heart and Soul Programs of India Bridget Life Ministries. And I wish that all of you are coming to the good summer of this year 2018. And children are preparing for writing their examinations. Now the home situations are comparatively a little tense because we need a concentration on facing such a great challenges, because children from various ages are in preparation to writing examination. I hope and wish that the God of wisdom may give you abundant wisdom to write these examinations. And believe that God is sufficient for you. The Word of God says that very clearly, that the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. So believe that God is with you and helping you to write the examination. There is no tips for any of you. Only thing is your attitude. The thing is, you need to learn that God has given you a bright brain, a fresh brain, a brain which is filled with the knowledge. So just operate it. That's all for you. Don't keep any tension and to break your heart. Nothing to worry about it. If you study very well, you will definitely write it. Some people are thinking that if I'm not studied, so I want to write it. How is it possible? So believe that the rest of your time, moments are sometimes sufficient. You need a mental picture of what you are going to write, in which subject you are going to write, and fresh up your mind and write confidently. So if your confidence is there, definitely you will succeed. So we look on the Lord and pray to the Lord for all the children who are going to write examination. Let's pray. Father, we pray this moment for all the children in all ages to write the examinations. Examination is one of the opportunity for us to prove that we are worthy to go for studies, high studies, as well as to receive the degrees. May your spirit should strengthen them, Father, because you are the source of wisdom. And I bless all the families preparing their children. Give patience to their parents, endurance to parents. Keep them more good heart for their children. And we pray for the teachers' community, and they are also in preparation to conduct the examination. And we pray for the evaluators, who are also preparing to evaluate the children's performance. Now we want to know that this is not for the sake of mark, but to improve the children and their capabilities. Take this opportunity as an enjoyment for children. No one should take it as a negative spirit. And also we pray for today's message, speak to us, Father. Thank you for helping us to continue to think of the good communications. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So I'm sure that families who stood before your children, stand before your children and support them, will definitely see good results. The Word of God is standing with us. And the Word of God is talking to us that you need to read and you need to listen well, in well meaning. Number one thing is concentrating on, carefully considering what it is written or what other persons are talking. Concentrate. When we are talking to a person, we should listen at that person. Listening is a capacity which God has given to you. So when you are listening, not you are listening only tone or a tune. You are listening the matters, the content of the message. So we need to understand this one. And second one is don't interrupt. If anybody is talking, if you interrupt means that will go to another phase of communication. That will actually giving irritation to the person who is speaking. So when you are speaking, no, do not interrupt the person. And we need to formulate the talk. So talking in different dimensions is sometimes difficult. When you are talking at a one thing at a one time, then only your brain will accept that messages. Otherwise, it will get confused. And also, some people are talking too much. That's also not good. Use maximum good words to communicate what you are trying to communicate it. So less talking, minimum words should explain very well to the people. That's a fine art for the people to communicate. And when you are in important communication, you took some serious approaches. Otherwise, people doesn't know that whether it is serious talk or not. You have to communicate them, this is a serious talk. So I want to urgently speak to you. I want to you to consider it seriously. Also say, don't preach while you're talking. When you're talking to a person, he does not feel that it is just like a preaching. So each word is carrying important things which you are trying to give to the person. So, we should know these elements while we are communicating. In James chapter 4 verse 17, therefore to one who knows the right things to do and does not do it, to him it is a sin. If you do not know, see, don't take it as an excuse. I do not know how to talk. Don't say, that's a sin. You should know what to speak and where to speak, to whom you should speak. There is no excuse for you. Many are talking that I don't have any responsibility of my talk. No, you are responsible. Take the responsibility of your communication, whether it is good or bad. If it is some mistake happened, you should tell, this is a mistake from my side. I accept it. And also, we need to be very careful about the volume of your voice. How much volume you can use it. I'm just talking generally these elements. Unwanted voice raising is considered as a violation. So morality that will question. Ethically that should not be accepted. So voice and the tone of his voice. Tone and tune and facial expressions and hand gestures. Hand also can communicate. So vulgar gestures, vulgar communication will bring punishment and it will give more problems. And sighing, or in case snorting, rolling the eyes and discuss and your body postures. So when you're communicating, you practice it. Practice it. No one in the world can say that I'm a perfect communicator. We are all making mistake. But if somebody makes point out our mistake, we are ready to accept it. So communication is a must. But we know that sometimes that will create a lot of trouble. In Romans chapter 12, verses 10 to 12 says about, be devout to one another in brotherly love. A love is a base for communication. Give preference to one another in honor. Honoring the person. Loving the person, honoring the person based on this word. Not lagging behind the diligence. Fervent in spirit. Serving the Lord. Rejoicing in hope. Preserving in tribulation and devoted to prayer. That should be our standard. That should be our standard of communication as well as our life. King Solomon actually gives two principles, general principles to us. It says about Psalm 141 verse 3 says, set a guard, O Lord, over my mouth, keep watch over the door of my lips. Set a guard. We must truly desire to guard our lips, where to stop, what to speak, what should not to speak. So we must put importance to honoring God with our speech. Our each communication should give the glory to God. Second one is Proverbs chapter 21 verse 23 says, he who guards his mouth and his tongue guards his soul from trouble. It's a very important word. He who guards his mouth and tongue guards his soul from all kinds of trouble. We must understand that if we do the guard our lips, we will avoid all kinds of trouble. King Solomon say, guard our heart in Psalm 4 verse 23. Guard our hearts, guard our souls. And save our souls from the trouble. All such things are depending on good communications. So communication is the power of life, and exchange is actually the balance of life. If you are not exchanging properly, what will happen? Life will be in trouble. In Genesis chapter 39, it says, Genesis chapter 39, the Joseph story. Joseph was the son of Jacob, a beloved son of Jacob. In his childhood, he got a lot of vision from the God. He explained that dreams before his brothers. And they got angry. Because in that dream, he explained that they all bowed before him. That leads to an enmity between these brothers and Joseph. One day, father sent him for searching for the whereabouts of these brothers with the food. They put him in a well. They wanted to finish this boy, their own brother. And God saved him from that moment, that scenario. And they sold this man to an Egyptian. An Egyptian sold him to some Ishmaelites. Ishmaelites sold him to Potiphar. Potiphar was an Egyptian officer with great influence. He was a captain of the guards of Egyptian king. And he took him into Pharaoh's palace and his home. He has entrusted everything with this man. And Joseph never questioned God and his integrity. He knows that my God has certain plan for me. That's why he put me away from my brothers and put me in a well now. And it's reading like this in Genesis chapter 39 verses 2. 1 and 2 says, now Joseph had been taken down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, the Egyptian, brought him from the Ishmaelites who had taken him down there. Next word is important, second word in 39. Genesis says, the Lord was with Joseph and he was a successful man. He was a successful man. And he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. Now the word is very important. He was a successful man. How to measure his success? Where were he right now? He is in a foreigner's house as a house worker. And he was sold by his own brothers and sold to Ishmaelites and Egyptians. He was away from his own father, his own brothers, and he was away from his protective layers. His life is not in protection. He is considered as a slave only. But the word of God says that he was a successful man. That's what I am raising this question, how to measure this success. And says, his master saw that the Lord was with him. His master Potiphar saw that God was with Joseph. That means the way Joseph is communicating with his masters, with others, are actually bringing glory to God. Otherwise, nothing there. But while he was communicating, the Potiphar knows that this man is a different man. There is a God is working in him. That means his total personality is exposing. His way of communication is exposing. The way of dealing was exposing his God to the heathen people. That's what he was sure, that there is a God is with this man. So dear one, like Joseph, we should be more transparent in our dealing with the people and God. Potiphar looked at him and saw that his God in his face. Potiphar knows that this man is believing ethical value, moral value, spiritual value. His God is with him. He is a big asset for me. And he says that the Lord made all he did prosper to his hand. Whatever he did, God gave a prosperity to this man Joseph. This is a big communication. Joseph was communicating very well to the people of Egypt that there is a God, there is definitely a God is living. So I put it in that sense, I put it in that perspective. This is the way he brought God into the land where people are not believing a proper God. This is a challenge for us. If we carry our God in our home, our communication is playing a vital role to give the God to the people of our home. And things are going in a totally different way. And we know that God was with him. That's what the word of God says. Now things are going to change it. Because the Potiphar, he had made him an overseer of his house and all that he had, that the God bless Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. And the blessing of the Lord was on that he had in the house and in the field. Totally, the prosperity touches the situations of Potiphar, the Egyptian officer. So he could recognize that because of this man, God blessed me. The prosperity comes to the home in a multiplying level. That's what the growth level was totally different. He could sense the real growth of his family there. We do not know more whereabout of Potiphar's life. But wherever Joseph's hand was working, God gave prosperity to Joseph. Through Joseph, that prosperity reaches the house of Potiphar. That's what the word of God is saying. This is also a way of communication. I am carrying the blessings of God. And I am sure I am healed from many sickness because of this word of God that has communicated me through Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ. Jesus through Holy Spirit is speaking to me that you are healed. I am healed. I experience healing. I was unable to speak. I was unable to walk also. God healed me completely from my allergic and my bone problems. Now I am the person is telling people about it. Maybe it is not all people, but at least people who are experiencing healing from the Lord can say like this. Here, the word of God says in Genesis chapter 39 verse 6, thus he left all that he had in Joseph's hand. And he did not know what he had except for the bread which he ate. Because the prosperity comes beyond the limit, he understood everything in the hand of Joseph. Potiphar was totally free. He could serve the king as an officer. Why should he worry about his home? Joseph was an answer for his search. And God honored him with prosperity. But after seeing this, Satan wanted to destroy this peace. He worked in the heart of the woman. Sexuality is another area where the devil can also play very easily. That's what it says about it. In 7th verse says, it came to pass that after these things that the master's wife cast longing eyes on Joseph, and she said to Joseph, 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 lie with me. But he refused and said to his master's wife, look at my master, does not know what is with me in the house, and he has committed all that he has to my hand. And also he said to his wife, Potiphar's wife, my master understood everything to me with except you. I am loyal to my master. So I cannot violate it. This is beautiful communications. When the temptation comes to our life, no need to entertain any temptations. If you entertain the temptation, that will actually conquer you. That will defeat you. That will reshape your understanding of the morality and ethical values. Yes, everybody practices. I can also practice it. But Joseph said, first of all, your husband, the beloved Potiphar, understood me everything. No chance. And second, there is no one greater in this house than I, nor has he kept back anything from me but you, because you are his wife. Now how can I do this great wickedness and sin against God? He make it spiritual. No chance to violate this trust. Because I am loyal to your husband as well as I am loyal to my God. So today's world need to listen this word. Maybe there are a lot of chances for doing the sins. Many temptations are coming. People are getting more chances. They can justify with more reasons, more facts. But here Joseph is there to stand with you, showing you that how could we prevent these kinds of temptations? I must honor my faith with my Lord, and also I must keep my faith with my Creator. Maybe people are, after people, you must think about your God. Because your eternity is secured. For doing a small sin, why should you violate this eternity? That will give you eternal dishonor. That will diminish you. That will give you your confidence problems, your trust problems. Let me tell you that today's One of the major problems is related to this issue. How to prevent the issues like this? How to prevent the temptations like this? Even if Potiphar's wife has enjoyed everything, but she wanted to enjoy the sin. Maybe people are having plenty. David, last week we discussed about he had plenty of wives. But now he wanted to experience one more, somebody's wife. That is adultery. He knows it. Ethically and morally, he is standing against of that adultery. But the temptation is so powerful. He gave his heart to the Satan to withhold his mind for a minute. He commanded that wife to come. Here is also wife. It is somebody's wife. Joseph said, no, I cannot spend time with you. I am not a big failure. I am a man only. I have attraction. But here I honor anything for the sake of my God, as well as the faith your husband put for over me. So you know that what will happen? In one occasion, she tried to catch him. He escaped. He escaped. That moment also he escaped. Because he was sure that Satan will plan. So Potiphar, by listening to his wife's voice, sending him into jail. That's what the word of God says. And in verse 22 and 23 says, the keeper of the prisoner of Joseph committed Joseph's can everything, and the prison, who were in prison, whatever they did there, it was his doing. And the keeper of the prison did not look into anything that was under Joseph's authority. Wherever Joseph went, he became the prime person there. Potiphar handed over everything to him. The jailer, he handed everything to him. What it says, because the Lord was with him, and whatever he did, the Lord made it prosper. Even if he is in a palace, even if he is in a house, even if he is in a prison, God prosper Joseph. Why? Because God is with him. In all these adversaries, all these difficult situations, all the problematic situations, God make him to success. A good communication is always essential for us to experience this prosperity. Who is defending your prosperity? Only you. If you fail to communicate well, manner to God, you will fail. Let the Lord heal us and help us to have a good communication with each other and with our God to overcome the temptations, overcome the problems. May God bless you. Shall we pray 1 minute? Father, help each one of us to overcome the situations. Joseph stood before us as a big leader. God anointed wherever he went. He made things possible because God made him a person, an ambassador of prosperity. Lord, we bless all the families who are watching this. Let them experience it, Father. Thank you, Lord, for your anointment. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for watching today's program.
And when I'm lost Shiva.